Hello everyone, I am Pallavi Nagaria, pursuing my bachelor's from NIT Jalandhar. Right now I'm in my final year 8th semester, and recently I got an offer from Testbook, intern+FTE, and I'm here to share my interview experience with you. So Testbook is an edutech platform where people can prepare for various government exams for like SSC, railway exams and various other exams. So it provides the study material as well as it conducts tests and live classes. So the basic process is one online assessment and 2 to 3 interviews, as we have mentioned in the selection process. And the number of interviews, either 2 or 3, will depend upon the process or an individual. So this was the criteria. And the company has came up for 2 roles. One was software developer and the other was data engineer. For that case, like I was interested in software development, so I applied for software developer profile. Talking about the processes involved, since first was the online assessment, it was basically a 45-minute online test on their own Testbook platform that they have. And the test consisted of 3 sections, quantitative aptitude, logical reasoning and programming. Each section had 25 questions each. And there was negative marking too in that, +1 for the correct answer and minus 0.25 for the wrong answer. And if you haven't answered any question, it was like 0 for that. And coming to the sections, it was quantitative, logical and programming. So in quantitative and logical, it was basically the basic aptitude that we have, like pattern questions. In the programming section, it was basically some data structures questions were asked, and some basic questions related to C++ or C were asked. Some like 1 or 2 questions related to DBMS were asked. So it consisted of the entire thing. Like in the DSA kind of questions, it was like they have given you the half, like the snippet of an algorithm and missed some of the statements. So you are supposed to choose the correct option, what will be there in the algorithm so that it would run properly. After the test was over, the results were declared after some time, probably some half an hour or something. And the results were declared on their leaderboard, like shows the leaderboard of all the people who have given the test, and would show the analysis, like which topic you were strong in, which topic you are weak in. And it also shows the subtopic, like even like if you have scored less in quantitative, suppose. So It also shows in quantitative in which section you were weak. So it was a very topic-wise analysis it shows, and it shows the it showed the result in the leaderboard. After the result, some 40 students were selected, and these 40 students comprised both data engineers plus software developers. After the results, I got to know that interviews are scheduled the next day. Since I had my interview the next day, it was like, we were informed that the interviews will start around 12 p.m. And I got my turn at around 1:30 or 1:40 something, my interview started. So the first round was technical, and it went for around 45 to 50 minutes. And the interviewer was a lead backend engineer at Testbook. He was very friendly and asked me to be comfortable and take the interview as a friendly discussion. The interview was divided into 3 sections, namely project discussion, coding question, and puzzles. So after, actually he, in the very starting, he told me that the interview would comprise 3 sections. Then he jumped on my projects, and I have made 2 projects. One is URL shortener, and the other one is a static restaurant site that I've made using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and Bootstrap as well. First he asked me to completely elaborate like how I made my first project, that is a URL shortener. And since I've used MongoDB in that for the database, so he asked me to code the schema and how I was like creating the short URL. In between he asked me, did you use any APIs or something? So I told him, yes, I was using. So he said, just code it like in a snippet form, the schema and how was I creating the short URL, saving it in the database as well as retrieving it. And he mentioned that I just have to write the pseudocode and like a snippet only. And yeah, I was asked to do it in the Google Docs, like he has shared a link. So after that, he gave me a scenario that I may lose a number of clicks done on the URL at the same time by different number of users. What if that happens, and how will I solve that problem? So at first, I got a little confused, like what kind of answer he's expecting from me. So I asked him like how he wants me to answer it. So he told me that I can solve it using a data structure, and I just have to tell which data structure would be the suitable one for this problem. So we actually had a discussion over it. It was not like a one-to-one conversation on this particular question. So we discussed, and he also gave me some hints like you can do in that way, think in this direction. So after the discussion, I deduced that Q would be the perfect data structure for solving this kind of problem in such a scenario. And after that, he asked me the difference between SQL and NoSQL database. It's like advantages and disadvantages only. And why did I choose NoSQL, like MongoDB, for my project? And yeah, one more thing he asked me after that, when I told him, when I answered this question, he asked me, what if I ask you to code your, like, to save your database using SQL and not MongoDB? How would I do it? So yeah, this one question I answered. And so after this, he asked me a DSA question. It was basically a binary search question. But the main challenge here was to recognize that binary search can be used here, since he really twisted the question. The question somehow went like, he asked me that we are supposed to work on an API, like I'm giving you an API and like a range of values which are supposed to be given as an input to the API, and some values he has given me that your API will give you such kind of a response. And he also elaborated about one or two parameters that are being used in the API. Like I have to suppose that these parameters are used inside the API. So he told me that now you have to answer how this API is basically working. You have to tell me the working algorithm. So basically there I have to find a pattern between the input, the output, and the parameter. The value that he has given me were a bit typical. So yeah, I have to find like a pattern between all of them, like the three, the input, output, and the parameter. So yeah, it was a bit twisted, but yeah, but when I got it, it became like far easy. And yeah, after I answered that, yeah, binary search is being used here. So after that, the basic questions were like, what is the time complexity? And I told him, and then he asked me to like explain why binary search is having this time complexity. So it was pretty easy. I compared it with the linear search, and depending on the number of operations that I showed. So I told him that this is having this kind of time complexity. And he also, after that, he also asked me to code it, like code like a pseudo structure of the API. Just do it. So it became very easy since I explained everything before that. And so after this, he moved to the puzzle section, and he asked me to calculate 98 into 102 without using a pen, paper, and a calculator. So I solved it using a plus b and a minus b technique. It was much easier that way. Lastly, he asked me if I had any questions to him. And in this section, you should never say no. You should definitely ask whatever questions you like. So I asked him about the tech stack that is being used there, and how did the company function and work during the lockdown period. Yeah, these were the some 2-3 questions that I asked, and he answered them. He answered them very comfortably and very friendly, and he was explaining everything in detail. So yeah, he was very friendly in the starting also, as well as in the end also. So after this, my interview was concluded, and after 1 hour, I was informed that I cleared the first round, and my second round is scheduled after an hour. So coming to the second interview round, it was also a technical round, and the interviewer was a lead front-end engineer at Testbook this time. And so he started with my introduction first and asked me, like, what do I like more, working in the front-end team or working in the back-end team? Like, basically, what do I like more, front-end or back-end? And yeah, he was not expecting any casual answer, like anyone or anyone I would like when I join. Not like that. He was asking, like, for a very precise answer, like either one of the two. So I asked front-end. And here also the interview was divided into three sections, DSA section, puzzle, and the project section. So he asked about my projects first, and after I was done explaining him both the projects, he suggested some improvements in both of the projects, like you can do. He also asked me to show my project on screen, but due to some glitch, I couldn't. But he was fine with it. He was satisfied because I answered almost every question that he asked. Meanwhile, the project explanation I was giving. And after this, he moved on to questions from HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and some other questions related to front-end, like how many types of selectors are there in CSS, and explain each of them. He also asked about some HTML tags, and he also asked, like, if I have worked upon animation, if I have used it in any project. Since I haven't used animation in any of my projects, so I straightforward said no, I haven't. So yeah, but I have read about it once, so I told him whatever I could remember, and I also mentioned that I have read it and whatever I could remember I'm telling you. So he was like, I have no problem. And some basic JavaScript questions, like difference between double equal to and triple equal to, and some other JavaScript questions, like basic JavaScript questions, like promise. Now moving to coding, he asked me to code how to find if two strings are anagrams of each other. And I gave him two approaches, one using sorting, one using extra space. And there is one more approach to this using hashing, but he was satisfied with those two, like the sorting and the extra space one. Like there is one more approach to this question using hashing, but he was satisfied with the other two. And after this, he asked me to code like both the approaches. And I coded both the approaches. After this, we discussed about time and space complexities of both the approaches. And he asked me, which one do you think is the most efficient algorithm? So I answered the algorithm which was taking less time. After that, he gave me a scenario, like what if I have less memory in my system and the files are huge, which are to be checked, like if they're anagrams or not. So first, I answered the first algorithm, like which was using constant space complexity, but more time it was taking. So when I answered this, then he like this time he precisely explained me the problem, and he said, suppose you have 4 GB RAM and both of your files which are to be checked if anagrams are not are 3 GB each. Now think which approach would work efficiently. So this time he specially mentioned, like, take your time, think and answer. So after taking a few minutes, I deciphered that the second will work fine here, as we will first read the data from the first file and then delete the file, keep and store all the information in the extra space that I've taken, thus maintaining space, and do the same with the other file, read the data and then delete it and check if they are anagrams from the stored data that I've used, and do the same with the other file and check if they're anagrams or not. And after this, he was satisfied this time. So after this, he asked me if I had any questions with him. So I asked him a few of the questions that I have in my mind. And I also repeated the question that I asked the interview in the first interview. I asked that same question in this interview also. So after this, he concluded my interview, and the results for the same came out the next day. Out of all the people, only 3 were selected. 2 were for the SDE role and 1 was for data engineering role, and I was one of the selected people. Talking about my preparation, since I had this C subject in my first semester, as well as I'm having a CSE minor, so I found myself interested in coding rather than my departmental subjects. So I started learning DSA, and like I picked up a language first and started learning DSA in that. And I used platforms like LeetCode and InterviewBit to practice coding questions, as well as I prepared DBMS, like subjects like DBMS, OS from YouTube and the books. So the basic key is time. It's a matter of time and practice. It's not like only IT people and CS people can crack it. Even people from non-circuital branches can also crack it. We just have to give time and perseverance in whatever we are aiming for. So yeah, that's the same thing that I did, and I cracked the offer. So now coming to the tips to crack Testbook. The first and the very important one is be very, very precise about whatever you put on your resume, because what I observed is in both the interviews, almost everything that I've put on my resume was being asked. And be very thorough with your projects and always be confident. This is the key to crack any interview. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to share my interview experience. Thank you, Aim2crack team, for having me.